Hi, I'm Fred Warmbier. Thank you for having me. Everyone knows Otto's story. It was played on TV. It wasn't private, so we can't. Everybody knows. And when he came home and I watched him die in the hospital, I made a commitment to him that I was going to do something about this. And so the journey began. And so we went to our government and said, we want to sue North Korea. They said, you can't sue a country. There's no law for that. So unless they are listed as a state sponsor of terror. So Cindy and I worked with our government. We lobbied the Congress and the Senate. And then it took about a year. And then President Trump named North Korea as a state sponsor of terror. Once that took place, we were allowed to sue them. And that's where we put the facts of what happened to Otto in front of a judge, a district court in Washington, D.C. And they created what's called a judicial finding. And they found that Otto had been taken hostage, used for political purposes, he was tortured, and he was killed. And so we were then awarded monies, and then we decided that we think dialogue with North Korea is not worth it. They're just not capable of meaningful dialogue. So we feel that the only way that North Korea survives is outside of North Korea, where they have operations and income-producing things that take place. It's all over the world, and they are not contested with any of this. The perfect example is the Berlin Hostel. They have a 400-bed hostel in the city of Berlin, right near the Berlin Wall. They make between 60 and 100,000 euros a month off this. It's illegal. It's against German law. It's against European law. North Korea is treated specially around the world. They're not treated like the common criminals that they are. If we treat North Korea like the common criminals that they are, and we force them outside of North Korea to obey the rules, perhaps that will start dialogue with them. We think it will, but even if it doesn't, the rules must apply to North Korea. They don't apply to North Korea here in South Korea. I'm saddened that Hwa Fu and the other people that have been abused by North Korea, they have no voice. And that's not right. So my hope is that you can discover ways to work with your government, so it's a government for you, and you need the tools to deal with North Korean abuse. And so that's what Cindy and I do, and it takes a long time. It took a year to make them a state sponsor of terror. It took another year for the lawsuit, and then we've had some successes. We were part of the Wise Honest that was taken from North Korea. We were involved in that, and we're proud of that. That took one of the largest coal ships out of their fleet. And that's all you can do to these people. You do enough of this for them, and they will change their behavior. And that's my commitment.
It's so nice to be far from home and have so many people care about Otto. I don't even have to tell you about Otto. You all know about him. I think that North Korea picked the wrong kid. We're not going to go away. I think I can attest to the fact that all of you feel the same way. And it's going to take a lot of work, but if we're committed to holding North Korea accountable for being the worst regime in the world, then we can take them down. but you have to believe it first. Fred and I could show you pictures of Otto before and after, and you'd believe it. When I looked in Otto's eyes and I saw he was blind, I saw the horror emanating from his face. Then I didn't need any more information. I am never going to stop until the day I die or until they're taken down. But I really need everyone's help everywhere in the world. And you're as close as you can get. So you have a lot of power. And I just keep saying, don't rely on other countries. Don't rely on the United States. You are so powerful. If I can stand up here and find my voice, all of you can find your voice. Thank you.
Odo원비어 아버님께서 1년 동안에 소송을 제기했습니다. 처음에는 미국 정부로부터 북한이라는 나라를 상대로 소송을 제기할 수 없다 했는데 수많은 노비 활동 끝에 1년 만에 연방법원에 로스를 제기하고 지금 북한의 선박을 억류해서 거기서 나오는 이익금을 우리 오토원비어와 또 한국인 선교사 두 사람에게 그걸 나눠준다 하는 이야기가 매스컴을 통해서 나왔습니다. 이 북한은 얼마나 악랄한 정권이나 하면은 지금도 세계 민주주의 국가의 시스템을 어뷰즈 악용하면서 지금 베를린 월 근방에 있는 유스 호스텔을 하나 운영을 해서 거기서 수십만 불, 수백만 불의 돈을 받으면서 또 정권 유지에 또 인권 유린에 계속해서 사용을 하고 있습니다. 그래서 이러한 일들을 위해서 우리가 계속해서 싸울 것이고 또 우리 어머님께서 말씀하시기를 이렇게 먼 길에 초대해 주셔서 참 감사합니다. 아마 김정은이가 사람을 잘못 선택했다 이런 말씀을 했습니다. You pick the wrong kid. 우리는 그렇게 다른 사람처럼 만만하게 볼 상대가 아니다. 여기 말씀하셨죠? Until I die. 내가 죽는 순간까지 너희 정권을 무너뜨리기 위해서 계속해서 싸울 것이다. 그런 중요한 말씀을 한 가지 하셨습니다. 여러분들은 자꾸만 다른 나라를 의지하고 다른 힘을 의지하려고 하는데 아닙니다. 여러분 자신이 우리 시민사회에 어마어마한 힘을 가지고 있습니다. 여러분들께서 저 악한 정권을 무너뜨리기 위해서 끝까지 싸워주시기 바랍니다. 그리고 한 가지 여담으로 말씀드리면은 일본이라 하는 나라는 납치자들이 오피셜리 17명밖에 되지 않지만은 싱가포르 회담에서 트럼프 대통령이 김정은에게 최초로 한 말이 북핵 문제 해결이 아니었다고 그래요. 최초로 터뜨린 말이 일본의 납치자 문제 해결해라. 여러분, 우리나라는 전쟁 납치자뿐만이 아니라 전후 납치자가 수십만 명이 되는데 소위 인권 변호사라 하는 이 촛불 대통령은 단 한마디도 우리 국민의 인권에 대해서 요구를 하지 않았습니다. 그래서 더 이상 이런 대통령에게 우리가 요구한다 하는 것은 무리고 우리 자신이 여기 6.25 납북자 인사가족협의회를 비롯해서 여러분들이 계속해서 그 북한 정권 무너뜨리기 위해서 힘을 합치고 싸워야 될 줄 믿습니다. 우리 다음 발표는 자기의 삼촌이죠. 아노치 판초이의 조카 되시는 안중 판초이 우리 태국 우리 납북자 가족께서 증언을 해주시겠습니다.
오늘 이렇게 이 가족회에서 이렇게 저를 초대해 주셔서 너무나 감사합니다.